Okay. Ready for the next question?
Yeah.
Okay. Advice needed. My boyfriend and I have been together for 7 years. We have a daughter and one on the way. The last 2 years before we recently separated have taken a toll on us. He has severe anxiety and took to drinking. I couldn't stand dealing with it anymore. He can't keep a job and refuses to stop drinking because he believes it's his right. Is he ever going to realize that me and his kids are worth it? Worth his effort to get back on his feet and stop drinking?
Wow. That's
Number
heavy.
One. Leave him alone. He's trying to have a couple of cocktails. Here's the deal, man. I'm a substance abuse dude. I've been sober for about 6 years now. It is a long and tough process to divorce yourself from yourself.
And is it one or the other?
Well, that's the issue. It's not... I don't know if the guy's an alcoholic. Yeah. I don't know if he's a drug addict. But, you know, in the most extreme cases... You got to remake yourself, and it's that's not an easy thing.
I think he's trying to
do.
Sabotage. It could be an option.
He might want out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is his way. That's
I don't know. It's a sickness,
left
though.
My second
he could be
marriage.
Addicted.
It could also be situational. He might just be miserable in this particular situation. And if he gets in another situation, he might be... here's the problem with marriage now.
You have a kid on the way.
Here's the issue with marriage, and I'll tell you right now. We have a society where people... are out for themselves primarily. God, family, none of these things matter. Like all of these institutions have crumbled. So people's main concern is themselves, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That doesn't really work when you're trying to have a partnership with somebody else. That doesn't really work. Like back, you know, certainly when we were-
Even when they choose a partner, it's for themselves.
Yeah, it's for themselves. Right. And it's like, there's no sacrifice being made on anybody's part. And I'm not saying you.
Well, you get less Instagram likes when you have a partner.
Right, right. But I'm not saying that like you should be in a miserable marriage. But like the idea that people just jump in and out of marriage. It's like it just feels like a weird like bar. It's like now it feels like, well, it's just the end of the bar crawl. Let's get married. And I'm not saying other people get into this not seriously. Yeah. And I feel like, you know, at the end of the day, it's like if you have a culture where the primary concern is me. Then it's a problem. Then 7 years in a marriage, you don't go, I got kids, I got to get my fucking act together. You go, I'm just going to get fucking hammered.
Yeah, well, I think, I don't know, what do you think started this whole narcissistic society?
What, him drinking?
No, I mean the culture
the whole
of me.
Overall.
Yeah.
I think it's an overcorrection to a culture that predated it, which was a culture, you know, where many, many people, whether they were black or gay or women, had very... few rights and didn't have a vocal part. Like, and at the end of the day, it's like, so a lot of those old institutions rightly were oppressive. They were oppressive systems and structures that held people down in all kinds of different ways. So now I think almost the overcorrection is people being like, well, fuck it. You know, like there's no value in anything that doesn't gratify me at every second of the day. And it's like all this shit is like, I'm on Instagram and like what I'm doing. And I'm living in my own reality show and I'm constantly posting. And my life is a show.
Well, it's a lot of celebrity, a lot of all that, of fame. And then also options. Like back in the day, you marry the person in your neighborhood.
You have too many options.
Yeah, you got so many options. So you tend to think, well, what do I deserve? There's so much out there. You know, I could meet 5 different guys this week.
Yeah, but it's
app.
Still the same way because on the app, it's proximity.
Yeah, but there's millions of choices.
But there's so many choices. And there's so many self-help books now where it's like you go into the bookstore and there's 25 books that are telling you that you were the most important person in the world. Yeah. How do you feel?
You're
Have
a star.
Have you created a new you?
You're like, a star.
So everybody's creating a new person every other fucking week. And all these kids are told in college that they should take all these... meaningless garbage and they're all going to be great writers and you're not. You're going to fail. And the only fucking thing you have is marriage and kids. That is really what most people have. You're not going to fucking be fucking Beyonce. You're lucky to have somebody that loves you and cares for you and you can grow old with. But we're telling everybody that they should fucking go and pursue these wildly unrealistic goals and just fucking put marriage and family, like, that doesn't really matter anymore. The happiest people I know are the people that are married with kids. They're not the successful fucking actors and comedians I know. The happiest people I know. So I think that it's a value shift where, you know, we look at all these people that are wealthy and they have all this shit, and we go, oh, that's what we need to do. We all got to be fucking famous. And we all got to get, I got to get 1 million likes on this picture of my breakfast wrap so I can start a blog and so the Food Network can partner with me and fuck you.
I love that you're just describing what you wanted to do.
But this is what a lot of people do. This is what a lot of people want to do now. They don't have any connection spiritually and morally to what's going to make
them
happy.
The only way a successful marriage happens is if you're rich.
Correct. I mean, I don't know what's... Am I stuttering? I think I've been very clear.
I went to Tony Robbins. I went to all those seminars.
I am the poor man's Tony Robbins.
You are.
I am Tony Robbins if you don't have the money and you want to get yelled at in Hill Country Chicken.
Different,
I am Tony Robbins.
Different teeth. Just different
Timmy Robbins.
Yeah, and they...
you should do seminars.
I like Tony Robbins, but is that really $5,000 is worth it for that ghoul?
She paid like 30. Oh, she ran on the hot rocks.
$50,000.
Oh, God.
Yeah. God.
But I went to all the...
Was this pre-camel toe tattoo?
Yes.
Or did you get that after?
I do like... Let me tell you, I do love Tony Robbins, and I think that documentary is amazing on Netflix.
It's great. Well, I feel like he made that documentary.
We watched that together.
The documentary was a lot like his
sales
pitch.
Why don't you marry Andrew?
Oh, God.
Oh, good.
I know.
Would you fuck Andrew?
I don't know if I'd marry Andrew.
Well, thank you, Tim.
He's not rich.
Fuckable, though.
He's good. He's decent looking, but there's something in there that's not there.
Yeah. Yeah. Like a dick.
No,
that's in there.
But like if you're a woman, if I'm a woman and I'm...
Yeah,
and
I can't provide.
That's what I mean.
Yeah, I get it. I'm not a fucking caveman that can bring home a fucking saber-toothed tiger.
But that's
for
the
you.
Other problem. We liken that to a caveman, you know? He's like, I'm not some caveman that can have a job and contribute to the bills, you know? I'm not some Neanderthal who's going to hit you with a rock or maybe have an idea of how to get us out of the mess I've created. You know, it's like we have this
I'm
new...
I'm sensitive.
It's this new thing now where it's cold. Like progressive to have no clue.